sometimes in the countries that we work with, they are given much more freedom, independence. Because of the difference in our transportation systems, the students have a lot more independence when it comes to jumping on trains and buses and taxis and just people that they don't even know in cars and catching rides. So they're used to a lot more freedom and independence.
And therefore, so when they arrive in the United States, and maybe they're placed in a more rural area, there is no public transportation at all, just because they're living in an environment like that doesn't mean that they're automatically going to be ready to be parented as a U.S. teenager would be. They still have been treated as an adult. So again, it's a matter of, it's kind of a matter of compromise from the host parent and the student, I think, for things to work well. Because we can't expect a student who's been treated like an adult for years to suddenly become a child, right? Where we can't, it's just not going to happen. We have to work with the student to realize, like, oh, it's okay for me to be parented for this 10-month period of time while I'm an exchange student, but then kind of enlightening the host parent that it's okay that they have these skills and they have these opinions that an adult might. It doesn't mean that they're disrespecting you. It just means that they're from a different culture.
Here, see their child, even though they're 18, as long as they're still in high school and living under the roof, they're kind of their child, and the kids are going to have to learn that they have to follow the parental authority. They might not like it, they might not agree with it, they might think it's stupid, but the bottom line is they've got to follow the rules and accept the parameters on their independence and their ability to come and go, their freedoms.
And they can do it for 10 months. I mean, I think sometimes when I have conversations with students about this, I remind them that just because you're allowing this to happen for 10 months doesn't mean that you've actually changed as a person. You're just allowing this to happen for this period of time, because when you return home, you're going to be back in exactly where you were. So kind of teaching them to have that duality in thinking is helpful in getting along with their host parents, I think.
Getting used to having to ask their parents, because typically it's going to be the host parents. They're going to be driving their exchange student to and from the different activities, or maybe a friend or something like that. So getting used to having to ask somebody for rides and realizing you just can't come at the last minute either. You have to ask. So.
Yeah, that public transportation is a big one. A lot of students might be very used to just being able to go out, but especially in maybe less metropolitan areas, there isn't that public transportation like Janelle was saying. And,
which is the vast majority of where our students are placed, in the small rural country
and so farms. Sometimes it doesn't click right away that they can't just jump on, that they do need to